Jason Red.
One more time. Can I see them?
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Okay, start.
Okay. Like I said, you want to use your hips. So what we see in those couple of clips earlier is that you're using a lot of your back. You're pulling a lot with your arms. So essentially what's going to happen, at one point your back is going to overload, and that's going to create some issues, and then it's going to be injuries. First you're going to feel soreness, and then when it's going to be overload, right away. Oh, we go one by one. So, slightly closer stance. We go down. Okay, so now you feel your hamstrings.
Yep.
Squeeze right here. Squeeze your ass, jump as high as you can. Yeah. Try to think about your arms are like ropes with hooks on them. right here. Feel the hamstrings? Yeah. Pull the bar on your hips. Heel, big toe, little toe pressing the ground always. Okay. Eyes up. Yeah. Pull the bar on your hips. Pull the bar on your hips and then jump. Yeah, eyes forward. Okay, so close your stance. Up, squeeze your abs, and yeah, much better, much better. Yeah, strongly pull yourself down. instead of just pulling with our back. See? Try with this. Arms, so we're going to use our lats to pinch the shoulder blades down, and we're actually not going to pick the weight up higher than this, because there is no use for you picking the kettlebell high. So it's called the Russian kettlebell swing. So we go back, toes out, knees out, heel, big toe, little toe pressing. Trying to pick her head up like this, so then she's creating a lot of tension right here, and of course she has to deal with it at some point, so she's gonna put her chest down instead of just putting her head down. So what I suggest, like, kind of like keeping the head in a neutral position. Yeah, just continue. Yeah, you got it. Yeah, you got it? Okay, this is first time for you?
Like this, yes.
So, it's okay, it's just you're squatting too much. It's gonna look much, much better. Okay, I'll see you again. Knees back, focusing, yeah. So this actually looks pretty good, but essentially what I want her to do is just pushing the knees back, because she's always it shouldn't go below your knees, because essentially you're creating a force by using this, so the weight should be right here. Okay. You got any questions about this? You want to try again? Try again.
You know what I realized? That when you do it here, you don't have straight arms. You're keeping them a little bit down.
Because it's... compressing the spine. So there are some things with breathing, exercise, breathing exercise, that can actually help you to decompress the spine. What we did on our first training session. So I suggest doing that thing like every morning and every night before. see this feel a lot different.
Yeah, it feels like volleyball jump, like right before.
Yeah. Lock your knees. Okay, so obviously this is like for step. Pushing your knees too wide. So essentially, here, your hips going back. Problem you have is not using your hips with your core and even like with your legs. So that's definitely a big thing for you now. So finding a good strength and conditioning coach and address your body properly. That's a must for you, because that's directly gonna affect your career for the that's either stepping on something, I mean somebody's foot or neck, or just jumping off. So essentially, what we're gonna do is use this. Absorb everything that you think when you jump. You absorb, you don't want to
just stick.
Stick. And then try to land off. Oh yeah, absorbed it. Oh, like on a hard rock.
Don't stick again.
Doesn't really matter, it's like a short period of the time, like the way muscle reacts. So essentially, what you can do is like a drop to a vertical jump. You can always play with it, like put some marker and try to touch it, target. I mean, you can do whatever.
You can throw your arms into it too for volleyball move. They can throw their arms back too for volleyball move.
Yeah. Have proper mechanics, like using your hips instead of just one group. So how she overloaded her back. She's using a lot of her back in her movement on the field, and then she's having a training session with her coach, and then she's again using her back, and then like in a life, in a real-time situation, every time she bends down, she's like this, always using her back. Then essentially it's going to overload. Too busy, like I have to babysit Ryan, babysit Buddy, you know,
Serbia.
Yeah. Yeah, you know how he likes it. So,
what do you think? Oh, obviously, this is a CrossFit gym, so you interval train, like super crazy interval training for, because, like, at the middle, I
Essentially, you don't know much. It's true. I'm glad you said that.
I don't know much. Yeah. But I'm cute, and I know how to dance.
You don't know how to dance.
And Ryan really likes my company. So everybody knows.
Any more questions?
Just a rehabilitation. I don't want to see you overload. I don't want to see you lifting big weights. Means that we come back to a second week.
Yeah.
So we do 20